Well, it's day one of the legislative session in Concord, and already the sparring between the parties is underway.
Republicans do hold a clear majority, controlling 297 of the 400 seats in the House and 19 of the 24 seats in the Senate. And today, they fired a shot calling for one newly elected Democrat to give up his seat, accusing him basically of being a lobbyist with a badge.
On a day that was supposed to focus on rules and housekeeping, an unexpected turn, with a motion calling for newly elected Rep. Mike Brunelle of Manchester to forfeit his seat, citing a conflict of interest.
The Constitution is very clear that you cannot serve two masters, that being the people of New Hampshire on one hand and the organization that you're paid to promote on the other.
Representative Brunelle, who is also the executive director of the state Democratic Party, had stepped out of the room at the time of the vote calling for an investigation. But that was his reaction when we showed him the motion.
They're not focused on the issues at hand, and this is one of the saddest political stunts that we've seen in New Hampshire history.
Do you have any intention to resign your seat?
Absolutely not.
Political parties shouldn't pay their staffers to come up and be legislators.
Also backing the investigation, Republican House Speaker Bill O'Brien, who calls the allegation, quote, very serious.
The Constitution will be the guiding force. Ethics will be a guiding force, too. None of us should be receiving money to advocate on behalf of our constituents. I hope it hasn't occurred here.
In a general court filled with lawyers, doctors, and small business owners that will take up bills that could affect all professions, this allegation could be seen as a bit of a stretch. And as an observer from the Senate, Democrat Lou D'Alessandro finds the action somewhat comical.
We're eliminating a job. We're throwing a guy out of the House of Representatives, denying him his $200 salary, and he'll be in the ranks of the unemployed. Is that justice?
What we're saying here is that his behavior of filing legislation that has a direct and clear nexus to his position in the Democratic Party is inappropriate.
Day one is in the books. The matter will now be turned over to a subcommittee on elections for review. The minority leader, Terry Norelli, weighed in on the accusation, calling it, quote, pure politics. Mm.